I'm Janet Lomax. I'm a news anchor at News 10 NBC in Rochester, New York. We're talking with teachers today. We're also going to be talking with the... That's one of the things I love about this job. There's nothing typical about each day. Every day is different, and I think that's why a lot of people get into news, because of the variety. I normally come in between 8:30 and 9 o'clock in the morning. I am part of the morning news meeting, and that's an opportunity to come together and toss story ideas to determine what we're going to cover that day. And I really enjoy helping to shape our newscasts. I spend a lot of my day writing news copy. I also spend a lot of my day doing news updates, and we tape those. And actually spend a lot of my time watching the clock, because this is so deadline oriented. When I was in high school, I was involved in the Louisville Children's Theater, Louisville, Kentucky. And that's a professional children's theater company. At the time, I thought I wanted to be an actress. And it was through my theater connections that I was introduced to television. We went to Wave TV in Louisville, Kentucky to shoot a half-hour production with this theater company. And it sounds dramatic, but this is true. I looked up and I saw all those lights, and I saw the cameras, and I saw the people running around, and then I thought, this is what I want to do. I want to do production. I want to be in TV production. I want to produce shows. By the time I graduated in high school and went off to college, I majored in radio TV production, working behind the scenes. But while I was in college, I also took some communication courses, journalism courses, and we had a television station. And I was asked to go in front of the camera and deliver the news. And that's how I really started this love affair with news. I started to work behind the scenes and ended up in front of the camera. And I love it. I've been doing it for 30 plus years now. Upon graduation, a week after I graduated actually, I was offered an internship program at Wave TV in Louisville. How about that? The place where I first discovered television. And at the end of that 13-week internship program, they offered me a full-time position. And to start out in a market of that size, Louisville, Kentucky, larger market than Rochester, I shouldn't say it's unheard of, but for a college student, unheard of. I worked at Wave TV for 4.5 years and was offered a position from WHEC, News 10 NBC here, in 1980, and decided to accept it. And then I came here. I don't want to say that I was isolated from racism. I'm sure it existed, but in my world, I don't recall overt racism. Thinking back on it as an adult, I remember there were times when we would go out for hamburgers. I recall my father always went in the back door, perhaps because he wasn't allowed to go in the front, but he never conveyed that to his three daughters, that he was going in the back door because he had to. When I graduated from college, that was 1976. Things had changed somewhat. It wasn't so much racism, it was ageism, because I was straight out of college and I was working with seasoned professionals. You know, a political reporter had been there 29 years. I was the new kid on the block. They felt I was young and I was learning, and that was my battle. No one ever said to me, you can't do this because you're a woman. And you've got to understand my background, my family background. I grew up hearing, remember, you're a Lomax. My mother would say that to my two older sisters and myself. That was empowering. So to think that someone would say to me, because you're a woman, you can't do something, it never entered my psyche. We knew we could do anything we set out to do. And race or gender really had no foothold in any of that. I had an opportunity to sit down face to face with Michelle Obama, and it was more than wow. I'm sitting with this other African-American woman who happens to be the first lady, who happens to live here at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue at this White House. And then there's another aspect to this, and it goes back to my parents. For someone from my mother's generation, our father's generation, to see an African-American man as president of the United States, they probably would never have thought that could have happened. But here it has. You can be whatever you want to be as long as you're willing to work for it. Anything is possible. You know, it's that remember you're a Lomax. Remember who you are and whose you are and what you represent.